epitome of glamour and ability, Eve Torres.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring from Denver, Colorado, Eve Torres.
Don't get it twisted. Eve is more than looks. She holds a black belt in jiu-jitsu after training with the most notable family in...
Oh, here comes trouble.
But also here comes one of the top young talents from NXT.
And from Tampa, Florida, JC Jane.
Jane is a multiple-time NXT Women's Tag Champion, co-holder of the longest reign in that title's history.
And we are...
Eve Torres poised and ready for action here tonight, and I think it's safe to say Eve's proven time and time again that she knows how to make it to the top of the women's division and to the top of WWE, no matter what it takes.
I'm not sure I like what you're implying. For years, people have called Eve manipulative just because she knows how to get what she wants, what she deserves, both inside and outside of the squared circle.
She's got the shoulders down. And she kicks out.
Not enough to get past the one count yet.
Directly to the neck.
Arm is grapevine. Try to step through. Here it comes.
Tequila Sunrise. Think about all the paint.
Oh, really target back on the knee. And she's able to roll back on her spine and get out of it. Bullseye with the drop kick.
My dragon screw targeting the ankle.
And now you have to quick pin attempt here. And the shoulder's up in time.
For a match that's only just begun, that was a close count.
Reminding her who all these people really paid to see. If there's one thing that makes Eve Torres stand out from the rest of the women's division, it's got to be her jiu-jitsu experience. She should be able to use that to her advantage here in this one. Taken down with a body slam.
Got their opponent set up.
Drop kick to the back.
Never saw it coming.
A mounting. JC has taken out a lot of offense now.
And Eve's jiu-jitsu expertise is clearly serving her well. Not really an answer to that, now is there?
Big clothesline! She's going for the cover. Lifts up the shoulder.
Yeah, this early, no chance.
Stop, stop, stop! This is nasty!
A merciless attack. Hang on a second. We know that music.
The attack just got interrupted.
But their opponent's recovered.
That superstar is in the head of the other.
Obviously, the mind games were highly effective in this case.
JC Jane turns her attention to the WWE Universe. Right to the kidneys from behind. Is wearing her down.
And this match is not over yet. Things are only going to get harder from here.
Quick return to the ring. Dropkick!
Oh, great height.
And Torres has taken control.
Jane is really having trouble with her defense.
Oh, a dragon screw ankle breaker. Wow, that hurt. We got her covered. Kick out. She still has life.
Now is not the time to wallow in disbelief. Pressure must be kept on.
Shoulders down. Could she finally put this away?
She breaks the ref's count.
She is not done yet.
The way this rivalry is heating up, guys, hopefully cooler heads will ultimately prevail.
Yeah, the jabs, the disrespect, things have definitely escalated over the past couple of weeks.
How close was that? That was about as close as it could get without it all being over for her.
The heaviest artillery has been used, but it's not enough for the three.
Sharp chop.
Evading offense.
Where's the honor in that?
Powerless position to be in right now. Targeting the throat there. Oh, look at. Rapid fire stops to the back. Stopping the arm. An uninterrupted surge against Torres here.
JC showing off that wide array of hers.
Hooked up. DDT.
And a drop kick. Picture perfect. She's lost some of that energy she had earlier.
Well, all things
from way up. And she doesn't connect. Placing them right where they want them into the corner. And that definitely made solid impact.
So ruthless.
Eve going up. Launching.
Such a risk taker.
And that was an efficient display of offense with that maneuver.
Jane is really having trouble with her defense.
Into the cover!
Kicks out after one. Wow.
Eve Torres kicked to the gut. Has her opponent
back into the heartbreaker.
Now Eve needs to end this.
For the win!
Two!
Hangs on!
But can it be done again? How much is left after that? Was not able to seal the deal with her best move. Now she's asking, what more can I do?
Ooh!
It's been a hard-hitting affair here tonight.
These competitors are going to have trouble walking on their own after this one. An elbow drop for added measure.
How's that for a counter? She did her homework there. Mat slam
with some attitude.
She's getting back up,
but she might be down again soon.
Whoa!
Uh-oh. Oh, God! Wildly throwing your body out of the ring like that is more often than not going to provide such a result.
That was an example of boldness backfiring.
One kick. Two kick.
Couple kicks in a debilitating clothesline delivery.
JC sidestepped out of the way.
Then kick right to the gut.
And
oh! What a lariat!
And JC continuing to dish out punishment.
And we're getting to a point where JC has to find a way to end this fight.
Six.
And now she delivers her back into the ring.
What are you waiting for? Get back in there.
You tell him, Saxton.
Oh, an elbow drop for added measure.
Oh,
oh, oh. Oh man.
Look at this. Snap suplex.
And JC Jane gets all the discus big boots.
Torres is done.
fair and square.
Sure, if there is apparently a new...
Luckiest man in WWE history.
Plenty of luck, but plenty of success, too.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Kansas City, weighing in at 275 pounds, Happy Corbin!
I am so tired. Happy Corbin running his mouth. He's got to be the most obnoxious.
Half man, half amazing, all MVP.
One of the most brilliant minds in WWE.
His opponent from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 259 pounds, Montel Vontavious Porter, MVP!
One of the greatest minds in this industry, MVP.
Whether it's matters of business or competing inside the ring, many respect MVP as a savvy individual. He has the gift of seeing opportunities others might miss and taking full advantage of them to find success for himself.
You know, I'd go so far as to call MVP one of the greatest minds in sports entertainment, period. The way he dissects opponents and has contingencies for his contingencies, frankly, it's unreal.
I think you're being a little over the top, but it sounds like we both expect MVP to impress us with his mental game in this match.
Well, he's about to get a rude awakening in the form of Happy Corbin.
Yeah, the only thing more relentless than Happy Corbin's physicality is that uncomfortable, good attitude he has. The guy just enjoys beating people up.
Tossed a substantial distance.
Just as damaging as his actions.
And down with the suplex.
Into the pin attempt. Kick out at one.
He is certainly sending a message, getting his shoulder up before two.
Corbin gets out of the way in time.
MVP is truly one of the experienced superstars in WWE. How do you account for that kind of experience and ability?
You cannot be intimidated by MVP's veteran status. Hit him as hard as he hits you, and treat MVP like any other opponent.
And Baron now is being chopped down.
You're not going to find any remorse, just hurt from MVP.
Able to give him the slip.
There's the torture rack.
Racked up, not finished yet. Gets tossed into the ring. Got him set up in the corner of the ring. Oh, red in there.
Now this is a textbook example of how to bend the rules.
Using the forearm to their advantage.
Just how desperate do you have to be? Why not a fair fight, huh?
He leaves the ring, but he could lose this match by count. Mistake made by MVP.
Off the barricade.
Boom!
Great reaction.
Ooh.
Big forearm.
squatting too, my gosh!
What are you guys thinking?
Obviously not about the ref's count, Cole.
He'll head to the ring. Moves outside, what's the plan here?
Just became even more pleased with himself after that maneuver.
What's coming next? Back suplex. Very nice. Fends off the attack with an elbow.
Both competitors showing how well they know one another.
Running out. Gets inside the ring. No idea what Happy Corbin finds so amusing right now. Happy Corbin secures the win.
Here is your winner.
Maybe
Happy Corbin.
A count out is always a tough way to lose.
Not the win they wanted, but it's a win nonetheless.
Their opponent stepping inside this ring. These two ready to go.
Time. She assaulted her as soon as she stepped through the ropes.
No surprise here. These two cannot stand each other.
This is going to be an intense matchup.
Well, clearly, the advantage goes to the one who initiated the attack.
Of course, the other supers.
Can she keep her down? And a shoulder in the air.
Not even a near fall there.
Nasty kick.
Looking wobbly in the corner.
Jumping clothesline in the corner. Finds its target.
Fistbuster!
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
She wants to put an end to things here.
To the sky. She manages to get control.
And a bulldog to follow it up.
Indy Hartwell is still relatively green when it comes to action in the WWE ring. How is she going to stack up against this opponent, Corey?
Experience is a factor, Cole, but raw talent always prevails. Indy Hartwell's innate ability has proven her to be a top superstar no matter where she steps through the ropes.
Indy denies the attack. Oh, back elbow.
Hit the ropes.
Ooh, what a knee strike.
The better part of valor.
Katana Chance trying to get the crowd on her side.
Heads outside, but this one has to end in the ring.
Shut off clothesline.
Two.
All the way up. Still up. Squatting too, my gosh.
Meet the barricade. Delivered into the barricade.
Face from up the barricade. She goes back inside the ropes. And guys, she's dangerously close to a count out loss.
they're using the knee.
And finds a counter. Big time lariat. Starting to fire up. Where is this superstar getting this? Will it be?
I think so.
And a kick out at 2.5.
Both competitors digging into wells that didn't even know existed.
You know, I've noticed some friction lately between these superstars.
Well, you can't be friends with everybody. It was the same. There's definitely something of a rivalry here.
Hammerlock.
Reverse DDT.
Indy's got the juices flowing now, gentlemen. Oh, reversal catches Hartwell.
Takes their breath out. Effective counter.
Indy Hartwell with a springboard elbow drop.
Indy is just about to finish this.
Shoulders down.
And the kick out.
Oh, that was more than close. That was inches away from three.
Millimeters.
There's got to be some sense of desperation right now. She's used her best weapon, but the match still continues.
Two count. And that's it. Indy able to score the win.
Here is your winner, Indy Hartwell.
What a hard-fought victory tonight, guys.
Sometimes your plans work. Sometimes they don't. Their plan of attack just didn't have the desired effect.
Or maybe you shouldn't be planning to win by using cheap tricks in the first place.
Perhaps the most entertaining Hall of Famer in history.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from the Isle of Samoa. Weighing in at 425 pounds, Rikishi!
He's held the Intercontinental Championship, multiple tag team titles.
And Kishi may be the best dancer in WWE history, besides you, Cole.
Thanks, Corey. I won a number of dance contests.
Hey, did you guys know I used to watch Rikishi tapes to get ready for my 8th grade?
Anyhow, Corey, what do you think about Rikishi and his career?
I think Rikishi is one of the most fun-loving yet dominant WWE superstars we have ever seen. Deceptively agile, hard-hitting.
The Prince has arrived. A man who has passed judgment on all of WWE.
And his opponent, representing the Judgment Day, from Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 190 pounds, Finn Balor.
The Prince has a... I've always questioned Finn Balor's motives, but there's no mistaking what his intentions are these days.
Yeah, Michael, the selfishness and animosity we've seen from Finn Balor has really put a sour taste in the mouths of the WWE Universe. I understand that he is concentrating on taking care of himself, but I don't think this ruthless attitude is the answer.
Yeah, and we have to start asking how far Finn Balor is willing to push this and what his endgame is.
And across the way is Rikishi, a celebrated Hall of Famer with a legendary, fun-loving attitude. He's grappled with some of the meanest superstars this business has ever seen and did it all with a big smile on his face.
He's also humiliated some of the meanest superstars we've ever seen with his unique rear-end offense. Like you said, Saxton, Rikishi's ability to take on big challenges and still have fun is truly remarkable.
The damage he's taken is starting to pile up.
It's nothing he hasn't been through before. And here's an early cover. And a good strong kick out there.
He's trying to get this done fast, looking to avoid going into deep waters.
Taking a trip outside, but he's got to be mindful of the count.
Dominating shoulder tackle.
Able to elude it.
Oh, man, Rikishi is a man on a mission now.
What a forearm. Solid punch.
And it looks like that opened Balor right up.
He's looking a little weary now.
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing now.
And now thrown back into the ring. Had it scattered and met with a back elbow. Getting him into the corner. Running hip attack. What impact. Rikishi is picking the competition apart.
Yeah, Rikishi isn't giving any quarter.
What kind of offense do we need to see from Rikishi tonight if he wants to come out on top of the win?
We need to see his versatile offense. Rikishi's a veteran with a deep playbook. He can throw hands, toss you around, or even come flying off the ropes. He needs to unleash all of that on this opponent.
Hit drop.
I've been waiting to see that.
Closer and the bell would have rang. Momentum here. Rikishi is digging deep into his playbook, utilizing some versatility.
Oh, and a headbutt.
Oh, Rikishi ready to go.
Not done yet. The wheels are turning for Rikishi as he ascends up the ropes.
Oh, shaker.
Balor's in deep peril here.
Here is your winner, Rikishi!
This was as dominant a win as I've ever seen, guys.
This is what you get when you have complete confidence and control of the... Oh, joy, it's Daddy's little princess.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from Prior Lake, Minnesota, Tiffany Stratton.
She was a standout gymnastics athlete turned in-ring competitor.
Impressive how she's adapted.
Well, she had the best training that money can buy. Here comes Alexa Bliss.
And Lily, too.
And from Columbus, Ohio, Alexa Bliss.
One of the smallest competitors in the women's division, but she matches underrated power with hard-hitting, high-flying attacks.
Lots of titles and main events to back up those claims.
There have been few superstars who are harder to pin down than Alexa Bliss. We genuinely never know what we're going to get.
Absolutely. We used to know exactly who Alexa Bliss was. Now, she's flipped that script and become something almost nobody recognizes.
Bliss loves to keep her opposition uncomfortable, and whatever Alexa's goal is tonight, I'm sure chaos will be the main ingredient.
And we'll see if she can remove...
Front face line applied into the guillotine.
What's going to happen here? I think she's going to...
Fighting desperately. Able to shrug off her opponent.
Got to find a way to get out of this. Stomps the legs.
And spread. Oh, no!
Stationary position. Turns around.
Well,
moonsault.
Incredible agility. Not only does the standing moonsault physically hurt, but it's got to bruise the ego, too.
Kick hits the mark. Tiffany Stratton comes from privilege, as we know, but she won't be able to buy her way into victory here.
I dispute the idea that she needs to. The two things that will win Stratton this match are her meanness and her competitive streak. You can't teach those, and you damn sure can't win.
Discus lariat.
Looking for an early pin.
A kick out after one.
She's not going to go that quietly.
Really just laying it in.
Tiffany throwing caution to the wind.
She has her target weighed and measured.
From the top.
Diving drop kick.
Things taking a turn for her now.
Yeah, but too soon to be worried. Ooh, look at her answering back.
Showing of control and aggression, something they'll want to keep up.
A nice shot by Alexa Bliss. A cross body from the middle rope. Can she score the pin? Getting the shoulder up before two.
She likely knew that wasn't enough. She's just keeping the pressure on.
Continuing to work on their opponent's arm.
Turn it into an arm breaker.
Ooh, what a forearm club.
Oh, Tiffany avoids contact.
Right across the face. She got launched. She's taking things to ringside.
Driven down face first.
Stationary position. Turns around.
Well,
oh, moonsault.
Incredible agility. When you have the skill, you flaunt it, and you make it hurt, too.
Caught in a bad position here.
The apron can do some serious damage. It might be worse than being hit with a steel chair. Goodness gracious. And repeated impacts like that will weaken you mentally as much as it does physically.
She heads out of the ring, but she needs to pay attention to the ref's count. Takedown, and now punches, rights.
Oh, my God.
One, two.
Uh-oh.
Jawbreaker.
Call the dentist.
Three. Alexa can't yield any attack coming her way.
Stratton showing that competitive fire, letting her meanness do the talking here.
For wear in the corner now.
Oh, strong impact.
And Bliss effectively rocked by some well-timed offense there.
Yeah, but you can't count anyone out yet. This match could still go either way.
Oh, look at this. Show it off with a big flex. And then a kick to the back.
The arm drag there.
Big form. Guillotine applied.
fighting desperately. Able to shrug off her opponent.
Shoulder to the stomach.
And Stratton is showcasing her arsenal.
Alexa has to find herself an opening.
Rope assisted drop kick. Will this be enough? She kicks out at one.
She shows that she's far from finished. Hey, we're all getting free tickets to the gun show.
Kick to the back.
We've lost the lights, and I think we all know what that means.
Trouble. That's what it means, Cole.
Set up in the corner.
If you can get past the good looks, pay attention to the athleticism. What a move by Stratton.
Alexa's chances are dwindling.
There's two. And that'll do it. It's finally over.
Here is your winner, Tiffany Stratton.
This is a big win for them here in a must-win match.
This win might have put her ahead of the pack.
She certainly grabbed the spotlight with this victory.
Matchup underway.
Oh, no!
Oh, gosh.
Inadvertently strikes the official.
This is not the way to kick things off. Is that an official start?
The referee was able to start the match, so we are proceeding with this match.
We all know just how much a calculated attack like that could affect the course of this match.
Getting a leg up on the competition is the name of the game, Saxton. Work smarter, not harder.
Oh, stomping away. What are they going to do here?
Leg snap!
The other end, too.
Reversal! Can she capitalize?
He slips out of the way there. What reflexes?
What a punch! We know Rhea Ripley possesses an immense amount of power. Corey, is that enough for her to take home the win here tonight?
A superstar like Rhea Ripley isn't at their peak because of one attribute. And frankly, you should know that, Cole. Rhea Ripley is successful because she has tremendous ring IQ and dominating presence. That's something that takes years for people to learn.
Heads out of the ring, but needs to be mindful of the referee's count here.
She's forced onto the defensive now.
She's got her here.
Wow, clubbing blow to the back.
No.
Little psychological warfare at play here from the nightmare.
Oh, just deadlifting their opponent and tossing them aside.
Just a perfect mix of pure power and bad intentions.
She's in danger of a count out here.
I don't know if she cares.
Oh, just turn that around. And over.
Just got thrown around like a sack of you know what.
Stop to the gut, too.
Rousey has her up.
First pick.
Shoulders down. This could be it.
Kicks out at 2.5. And we know for a fact that this is just not some casual matchup. Guys, this rivalry has seemingly reached critical mass.
Well, I'd actually say it could be worse, Cole, but it's definitely not great as it is. The lack of respect these superstars have for each other is astounding to watch. They hate each other, simply put. And who knows what it will take for them to actually resolve their issues.
Strong kick.
My goodness.
Rhea Ripley with the defensive tie.
No doubt Ripley just ended this.
She shoots up the top rope.
Dangerous thinking. Taking flight.
Whoa, look out. Showing absolutely no apprehension to putting one's body on the line.
Right in the face.
My God.
And Rousey avoids that one.
Oh, look at this here. Arm wrench. Oh, she's starting to tire a little.
Ronda's MMA background has her well prepared to pound an opponent like we just saw.
Turns the tables on Rousey. Uh-oh. Slingshot sent on to the outside. Just a devil-may-care attitude on full display.
Going for broke, and it pays off.
She throws her back in.
Rhea getting everyone in attendance to rally behind her.
Why is she still boasting around? She's in a fight, for goodness sake. Brilliant counter by Rousey.
Amateur takedown. All the way over.
It could be over here.
This is it.
I can't believe my eyes. She just kicked out.
She kicked out? No way. She actually kicked out?
Goes under the ropes to get back inside.
Oh, toss across, and an elbow drop to the arm.
Ronda Rousey.
There's a body buster.
There's two! And that does it. Ronda Rousey!
being on the receiving end of an underhanded attack and winning it all? Impressive doesn't even begin to describe it.
Some might say lucky does, though.
This competitor is in bad shape.
Now the official should call this off.
I think it's the opposite. We're still gonna have this match.
Not a bright decision. I believe the attacker was probably a bit worried about this match, hence the sneak attack.
You gotta respect the determination of this competitor, despite that sneak attack, still willing to compete.
They're brave, even if they are dumb.
After a shotgun attack during the entrances, this match has found its way inside the ring at last. Now we can really get things started.
And you know, I just hope we have a clean fight here moving forward.
I'm not sure you should get your hopes up. If that starts anything to go by, we are in for a drag-out slugfest here.
No.
Slingshot cross body to the outside.
And here we go. Ball looking to the armbar. And here we go. Ball looking to the armbar.
Trying to maneuver herself to escape and successfully does.
Relatively early into her WWE career, Caden Carter has seen a tremendous amount of success, Corey. You think there's any way her opponent can try to derail her?
Of course, Cole. While Carter's an incredible athlete, it's fairly easy to overpower her. If you can use your strength and keep her close, you should be able to prevent her from getting the speed for that patented high-flying offense.
And surely she hears how high the referee's count has gotten at this point.
Well, if she does, maybe she just doesn't care.
Pitching their opponent. Look at these multiple knee strikes.
And look at this now. Bad intentions coming with this hole.
Oh, Black Widow. Almost a miraculous escape and a side slam.
And she slides her back to the mat.
Carter putting her opponent on notice.
Strategy. She thinks she has it.
Oh, somehow.
She's still got a lot of stamina left.
Oh, the reversal by Becky Lynch.
Nice takedown by Becky, looking for the armbar.
Disarm her, cinched in.
Locked in. This will break your arm in a hurry.
Oh, this trap, but she gets away.
Uh-oh, Lynch is holding in.
Becky in full control here.
Match from before the bell even rang.
This goes to show that breaking the rules doesn't always pay off.
No rules were broken, Saxton, but it was almost worth the risk if you ask me.